Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Tyler Lawson. Today we're back at it again with another the fantastic the special reaction, and that is we're gonna react to is The Walking Dead final season. Now we are on part two of what's it called? Acheron, I believe. Yeah, Acheron part two. Last time we did part one, now we have part two. Now last time, I was running late and, you know, try to do something, I don't know. But yeah, man. So last time, they still got captured by one of those white soldier Power Rangers. Or probably Red Ranger, and I don't know, man. I just feel like, it's getting ridiculous, man. Cause I don't know what's been going on or what is happening. I just feel like I still have some bad feeling about it, just in case. So yeah, and Negan tried to find out where they are, and Maggie's still not liking Negan, which I don't understand. I mean, I get it. He's still mad about what happened, but we all gotta lead to the past and focus on the future, and that is try to survive for as long as it takes. And even though that he mentioned Glenn's name, where it was supposed to be, not mention it. And now Negan left Maggie almost got killed by the walkers, I believe. I mean, I think she would be okay, cause, who knows, cause if that happened, then, I don't know, I just feel like I would be very, very, very shocked, and, yeah. Well, that leaves all of us shocked, so yeah. But, I heard it's gonna be, like, 1 hour long, so I'm probably gonna react to it as long as I can. So, yeah, but let's check it out in 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh. Damn.
From The Walking Dead.
She has been playing dictator since we left.
I'm calling the shots because that's how everyone voted. As for me killing you, it's always on my mind.
We are auditors for the Commonwealth. You are under level one assessment.
Let's go!
Oh, Lita!
Yumiko!
I have to stay.
I think Leela, part of your family been captured too. Oh,
Safe bet that they all are. Where's Maggie?
She was right behind me.
Somebody boost me up.
You go up there, you're dead.
She'd be pissed if you tried.
She'd want us to keep moving forward.
All right, we need to get that door open. And then we'll go from car to car until we hit the front of the train. Then we'll hop off. And then we just keep going.
Look out, guys.
Find a way. They gotta put me safe. I don't want the sad thing happen to my dog, because it'll be worse if that would happen. Something bad. What's that? United. Is that Washington, D.C.? Truth and lies. What's that mean? No. What's that mean?
You know what this means, don't you? The photo board. The Commonwealth.
That was a wallet-sized photo of you, which means it was in your brother's wallet, which means he kept the wallet on him in the apocalypse, possibly for 10+ years. And who does that? He sounds awesome.
What?
And also what you said. So what's the plan?
They have structure. Laws. Someone here's in charge, and I'm gonna speak to that person.
That's it? The plan is talking?
Yes. Cold as ice, demand results.
So, nothing. It's just, it's your bro. You sure you can be cold as ice?
Yeah, I was a lawyer. Comes naturally. Look, I love my brother. I hadn't seen him in a really long time before all of this, and I assumed it doesn't matter. I'll be fine as long as I can speak to them. That was her last night. Did you see how she was looking at us? She knows we're fine. No one knows we tried to leave, or believe me, we'd be holding.
Ezekiel's gone. In anticipation of the next question, I looked everywhere, asked around. No one's saying anything. Someone took him. Someone knows what we did. He's just the first domino to fall. In anticipation of your follow-up query, I don't know how I know. I only know that I'm freaking out. It's probably because he told off the big guy. Oh, God, why did he tell off the big guy? We should talk to them. We should talk to them. We can come clean about who we are, where we're really from.
Eugene, for the last time, do not talk to the law enforcement. Or if you find yourself in a situation where you have to, you stick to the story. But what do we do? Wait, what? Be cool.
Ice.
You got one of our people? What have you done with him?
I demand to know where he's been taken.
Calm down. I don't know where your friend is.
Well, then there's no reason for us to continue this conversation. I'd like to speak to somebody who can actually give me answers. Who do you report to?
You want to speak to my supervisor?
That's right. We want to talk to the manager.
I mean, maybe he would have found out where our brother is. I mean, I tell you, man, I got a really bad feeling about it. I feel like I've been playing Resident Evil for quite some time. That. No, please, God, no. This is not good.
I'm not sure why you're here. You've already been assessed. You think you've been assessing me? No, dear. I've been assessing you.
You don't know anything about me.
Your community's large and organized. There's a bureaucracy, and you're part of it. You probably had a job like this before the world fell. If I had to guess, I'd say forensic psychologist. Perhaps you were an academic. Researcher? Your role is to assess threat for your community. You ask about who we were because someone above you has decided that that's a good baseline position from which to judge who we are. So you poke around the dusty corners of our brains, test our sense of boundaries with queries about our toileting habits. You raked one of my people over the coals due to a $2 bill? Which makes me believe your currency is the US dollar, and that you need to strictly control the amount in circulation. You use familiar money as a powerful psychological tactic, because you know how desperately people miss the old world. You want to understand what we're capable of, and whether we can enhance your community, or if we'd simply be a drain on resources. But the truth of it is, you need to justify your existence too. Because isn't it almost more valuable now to have someone who can haul the trash and keep the streets free from disease than someone who can write endless lists of questions, given that at the end of the day, you just need to rely on your gut instinct about whether or not the person across from you will or won't murder you in your sleep. But you're both people that follow the rules. I was a lawyer. I like rules. They bring order to the chaos. Which means you need me. I have reason to believe my brother, a thoracic surgeon, is living out the Commonwealth and is looking for me. I'd like expedited processing for my group, as per your community's asylum and immigration policies.
Where did you go to school again?
Undergraduate at Oxford, JD is from Harvard, which you very well know. Would you like me to list my professional credentials again?
Coffee? Stop moving. You're taking my nerves over the edge to a proverbial living skin, dear.
I can't help it. We've been waiting and waiting, and now I have to be really, really bad. Shouldn't have mentioned it. I'll be right back.
No, no, no more splitting up.
Eugene, if that fine ass dude in the orange suit just walked in with a coffee, things must be going good for you, right? Maybe she'll be out by the time I'm back. Vasque, ¿verdad?
A tu servicio.
¿Tú crees que hay alguna manera que yo pueda ir afuera y usar el hoyo donde usted hace que la gente orine?
¿Y por qué no se hace el baño?
¿Cómo con baño? ¿Hay un baño?
Vacío, a la derecha.
¿Y sirve? ¿Do you have toilet paper? Well, shit. I'm excited.
Okay. And also, Eugene, you're so annoying. And after this, I'm still worried. Come on, man.
What?
Damn it, man. I ain't worried about the reason. Oh. I know I worry too much, but this is serious.
Why don't you guys handle that one? You're getting tired out. Take over.
Is that the roof?
The walkers?
Below us. It's Morse code. It's SOS.
Is that Maggie? And here's Maggie.
Slipped. He saw, and he left me to die.
Yeah. Okay. So what?
You're just admitting it?
He tried to kill her.
No.
She was in trouble and I didn't help. There is a big difference.
Okay, so who's gonna help you now? Who in here's got your back?
Yeah, you don't need fingers to count that number.
She was just talking about murdering me. Sooner rather than later. And yet somehow, I'm the big old asshole because I didn't risk my nuts for her. I have been a golden goddamn asset for every single one of you.
And a burning hilltop that helped, huh?
I killed Alpha. All right, so yeah, I was helpful. Because if I hadn't done that, every person you know, their skull would be on a spike. I did what needed to be done. All right, I am trying.
Yeah, okay, I'm not buying a word of it.
Same.
Not, and it happens. We can get through the city without him.
Help! Help me, help!
Leave
it. Help! Help!
Gage? What happened?
Oh, we got lost in the tunnels. Walkers are everywhere. They might have died.
How'd he get in there?
I got a door open on the far end.
Did you close it? Gage?
Hey, this one seems a bit looser. Sasquatch, give me a hand.
We open that, they'll all get in.
He's right there.
I know he is.
What the hell with you?
Alden?
Come on.
Are you insane? Move! Move!
Maggie? Maggie! Open the door! Look, I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. I made a mistake, and I'm sorry, but I want another chance. Okay, I won't do it again. I won't do it again. I'll be better, please. I promise. Please.
Maggie, listen to me. We have time. We can get that door open.
Maggie!
We don't have the ammo to clear them.
Let us go.
Sorry. I can't.
Liar.
Been waiting for my friend Yumiko. She's in that room right there. I was wondering if you might be able to provide or procure for me an ETA for when she might be done.
No one's in there.
But I watched my friend walk in there with the two questioners, and I haven't seen her or them walk out. If you could just check.
No one is in there, sir.
My other friend went to use the ladies' room.
What? I need you to leave. Now.
Where'd you go? Where'd she go?
Ah,
is.
Bad memories.
Oh, what?
Nice walker now.
You guys don't want to look at him. Why? Why won't you look at him?
All that is the shell of a man who died a coward.
It's a hot take, Hug. Who's scared? They didn't deserve to die like that. In the worst way imaginable.
There are worse ways. Not worse. Before I found Elijah and his people, Herschel and I were alone for a long time. One day we came across this frail old man kneeling by a turned over grocery cart. It was full of scavenged clothes. He said were for his sons and daughters. Could we help him haul the cart back home? And he said he'd give us food for our trouble.
I remember that.
I knew that he was a liar. But I was starving. Soon Herschel would be. So we followed him back to his house. I held a knife to his throat and reached in his pocket. I pulled out the chloroform rag he was going to use on me. Stuffed it in his mouth. And then we went inside the house. And I locked my little boy in a room. And I went and searched the house. There were these three deformed, what do you call them, men?
Yeah.
They came after me. But I handled them. And the house was quiet. Except for this thudding sound that was coming from upstairs in the attic. And I thought maybe they had people tied up there that were trying to get free. So I walked to a door at the end of this hallway. And I opened it and I looked up. There's a set of stairs. And at the top of the stairs is this shadow, writhing, rocking. I thought it was an animal. Suddenly it fell down the stairs. It came right at my feet. It was a walker. It used to be a woman. Her arms and her legs been cut off, stitched up, her eyes gouged out, no tongue, and she was wheezing through an open, cauterized gash in her throat where her vocal cords had been ripped out, and her belly was round. Whatever was inside of there was trying to get out. upstairs and there were three more just like her. But their hearts were still beating. And do you know the first thing I thought? The very first thing that crossed my mind? If they're alive, there must be food here. So I took care of them. And then I found the food. Lots of it. And Herschel and I filled the cart with it. And we left. I don't feel anything when I tell you that. Do you understand me? Because that is what's out there. I'm seeing it. I lost something. And I don't think it's a bad thing that I did. Because it has made things so much clearer. What we have. In Meridian. It's right here. It has to be. Compared to everything that's out there. Because if it isn't,
it means we were lucky. It means that nobody has it figured out. Nobody ever did. And nobody ever will.
Topside?
Yeah.
Bad idea.
I lost Gage.
Where's the ammo bag? Where's the ammo bag?
I lost that too.
Fuck.
Stop. Don't waste that on me. That's all I got. Tell my kids I didn't die a coward.
Come on.
That was cool, man.
Done with my traveling companions.
They're being processed.
Processed as in administratively? Processed as in bologna or other meat stuffs? This inquiry of mine needs to know. I want to see them.
You like feeling nervous?
Nope.
Only one thing gets my heart up. When I'm out there, battling the dead, and the gentle swarm, it's just pumping every time. And not in a bad way. Here, mop up. I think that you can lie for shit. So don't lie.
Okay, I wasn't going to.
You weren't. That makes me like you. Keep doing that, it'll help you. If you don't, you get me. Use your words.
Yes? Yes, sir.
Good. Now, I know you're holding back. You know you're holding back. I'm gonna give you two questions. You're gonna give me two answers, truthful ones. You do that, you get to go. You get to see your friends again. Everything will be okay.
No, it's not. It seems like.
Ready?
I don't know if you're good guy or the bad guy.
And why were you at that train station? Eugene, if you lie, I'll know.
Okie dokie. Right. I have been holding something back. Frankly, I wanted to speak up before this, but I was afraid of what my friends would think. I haven't always been the most emotional fella. My 10,000 plus hours of death, loss, and fear have opened me up a little bit. In the course of our travels, I found this radio. Night after night, I would speak into the void, holding on to a what if. As fools are wont to do, I'm nothing if not a fool. Then one night, the voice came back from said void. A beautiful voice. We got to talking, and she was not repulsed by my musings. We spoke of train museums and ice cream cones. We laughed. We sang Iron Maiden. And we wanted to meet. So I got my friends to go to that train yard under the guise of asking whoever showed up for help for us three, because I knew they wouldn't go otherwise.
was thinking about was Stephanie. So yes, I lied. I've been lying this whole time because I'm afraid to lose the three friends I have in this world. And I lied to Stephanie about being from a large settlement because I was afraid that maybe she was not who she said she was. That maybe she was a femme fatale, laying a trap for a lonely heart. My track record in the romantic realm is spotty at best. I'm not one for whom any relationship come easy, particularly those with the fairer sex. And I am, in fact, a virgin. Even though I have observed the act far more times than I care to admit. Thank you for holding back your tears. I was hoping that after a suitable period of courtship, that Stephanie might be the one to change my unenviable status. Because deep down, I was hoping that maybe, in fact, she was my one true love. And now I've been forced to admit that in this room, and I'm humiliated by it. I'm afraid that if Stephanie finds out that I wasn't honest with her either, that she might want to have nothing to do with me anymore. So here I am. Very relieved to get that off my chest. Because everything else I've said up to this point has been a goddamn truth.
Infirmary. Medic steamed my face, gave me this nasty herbal cough syrup, and I slept.
Oh. Did you spike the cough syrup?
No, they took the lantern out of my room, and I fell asleep. Medic checked on me a couple of times, and then they brought Yumiko to visit. And then they took us to a holding room with Princess, and then they brought us here.
Yeah, thank God you're here too. We were worried.
Pursuant to Section 114A of the new Articles of Perpetual Union, in deference to traditions established by Article 1, Section 8 of the Legacy Constitution, and Article 14 of the Legacy UDHR, you have successfully completed initial processing and consideration for asylum and citizenship in these United Townships. When you walk through these doors, you'll be escorted to orientation.
You're free?
By a beat cop. Welcome to the Commonwealth.
Oh. I mean,
or to West Point, asshole.
I don't get it. What the hell changed? Why did they to question him? Hurry.
Oh, something.
Which one of you is Eugene? Hi. I'm Stephanie.
Oh! So that was Stephanie on the radio. I didn't know! Ah. Now I understand.
Who's that?
It's a letter from this kid to his parents. It's from back before.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, down in the tunnel.
Is there anything else down there?
Yeah. It's the same stuff you saw.
We heading out? We need to take a detour first. Arbor Hills.
What's that?
Hidden supply depot. Georgie set him up all over because we ran into any trouble when we were out with the survivors. Has ammo, food, weapons.
Where did you go?
Rest up there, restock, and head to Meridian. Radio tower marks that neighborhood. You know where that is?
Yeah. Come on.
All right. Looks like it's almost daytime. Oh.
Sure has gone to shit since last time I was here. Let's double back and cut through.
Oh! Oh! What the fuck? Down! We got a new enemy on the loose. I think so. Looks like all them guys wearing a mask trying to act like off the purge. Holy shit, that came out of nowhere. And they got hammers, they got bow and arrows, they got something new. Oh my god, we in for some deep trouble and I am so scared. I don't know what the hell. But I'm very scared, but yo, who are they? I don't know. I guess we will find out next time. But yo, that shit was crazy at the end. I don't know who they are, but it seems like it's gonna be the last new threats. Wow. That was crazy, man. But yo, I think that's gonna be it for today. It's gonna be a lot of shit's gonna be very crazy, and I can't wait to watch it once again. And yeah, man. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe if you're new here. Click the bell notification down below, and I will see y'all.